Hello, I am Rajat Solanki, Assistant Professor of Law at National Law University, Odisha, Cuttack. Today, I'll be giving presentation on criminal conspiracy. Chapter 5A, which provides for criminal conspiracy, was inserted in the Indian Penal Code in 1913, as the experience at that time showed that the dangerous conspiracies are entered in India and that the existing law was inadequate to deal with prevailing conditions. It comprises of two sections, sections 120A and section 120B. Conspiracy was originally used to explain the acts of agreement of those who combined to carry on legal proceedings in vexatious or improper manner. Section 120A defines criminal conspiracy in following manner. When two or more persons agree to do or cause to be done, 1. An illegal act, or 2. An act which is not illegal by illegal means, such an agreement is designated a criminal conspiracy. There's one proviso to this section. It says that no agreement except an agreement to commit an offense shall amount to a criminal conspiracy unless some act besides the agreement is done by one or more persons to such agreement in pursuance thereof. The explanation to section 120A states that it is immaterial whether the illegal act is the ultimate object of such agreement or is merely incidental to that object. Criminal conspiracy is a substantive offense in itself. In simple terms, a criminal conspiracy is an agreement between two or more persons to commit a crime. Two or more persons must be parties to such an agreement, and one person alone can never be held guilty of criminal conspiracy for the simple reason that one cannot conspire with oneself. A conspiracy consists not merely in the intention of two or more, but in the agreement of two or more to do an unlawful act or to do a lawful act by unlawful means. So long as the design rests in intention only, it is not indictable. The general idea of the offense of conspiracy lies not in the doing of the act or effecting the purpose for which the conspiracy is formed, nor in attempting to do any of the acts, nor in inducing others to do them, but informing of the scheme or agreement between the parties. The gist is an agreement to break the law. Conspiracy is a matter of inference deducted from certain criminal acts of the parties accused, done in pursuance of an apparent criminal purpose common between them. Unless any nexus or any link is established between two persons, there cannot be any conspiracy as defined in section 120A of the Indian Penal Code. The meeting of minds is essential, and mere knowledge is not sufficient for the offense of criminal conspiracy. The essence of criminal conspiracy is the unlawful combination, and ordinarily the offense is complete when the combination is formed. Unless the statute so requires, no overt act need to be done in furtherance of the conspiracy, and that the object of conspiracy need not be accomplished in order to constitute an indictable offense. The constituent elements of the offense of criminal conspiracy are, first, an agreement between two or more persons. Second, such an agreement must be to do an illegal act. Thirdly, or to do a legal act by illegal means. And lastly, an overt act done in pursuance of the conspiracy. The essence of offense of conspiracy is agreement and association to break the law or to do an illegal act. An agreement to do an illegal act which amounts to a conspiracy as long as the members of the conspiracy remain in agreement and as long as they are acting in the accord and in the furtherance of the object for which they have entered into agreement. It is essential for the offense of criminal conspiracy that it requires some kind of physical manifestations of the agreement. However, the express agreement need not be proved nor is it necessary to prove the actual words of the communication. The evidence as to transmission of thoughts sharing the unlawful design may be sufficient. Conspiracy comes into being just the moment the agreement to commit the crucial act is reached, and it continues to exist so long as the object for which association was formed continues in the process of fulfillment as per the agreement. Having carved an exception in the favor of agreement to commit an offense, which is punishable per se without proof of an overt result of conspiracy or any overt act in pursuance of the agreement, other conspiracies need some overt act besides a mere agreement to render it punishable. Offense of criminal conspiracy is complete even though there is no agreement as to the means by which the purpose is to be accomplished. It is the unlawful agreement which is the gravamen of the crime of conspiracy. The unlawful agreement which amounts to a conspiracy need not be formal or express, but may be inherent and inferred from the circumstances, especially declarations, acts, and conduct of the conspirators. The agreement need not be entered into by the parties to it at the same time, but may be reached by successive actions evidencing their joining of the conspiracy. There must be two or more persons for every criminal conspiracy under Section 120A of the Indian Penal Code. When two or more persons agree to commit a crime of conspiracy, then, regardless of making or considering any plans for its commission, and despite the fact that no step is taken by any such person to carry out their common purpose, a crime is committed by each and everyone who joins in the agreement. Thus, there has to be two conspirators, and there may be more than that. It is not necessary that every one of the persons agreeing to do the illegal act or act should be capable by law of committing an offense in respect of that act. It is not an ingredient of criminal conspiracy that the parties should agree to do a single illegal act. It may comprise the commission of number of acts. However, where several persons are charged with the same conspiracy, it must be proved that there is one large conspiracy involving all the persons charged, and not a number of unrelated conspiracies entered into by different groups of the accused. The unity of will and purpose amongst all the accused must be proved, and an accused not shown to be a member of large conspiracy is entitled to acquittal, however bad his record may be and however much he may be suspected of this or that offense. Where the accused cannot be said that every one of the accused was in agreement to do the same illegal act or cause same illegal act to be done, they cannot be held to have been parties to one and the same conspiracy within the meaning of this section. Now, consensus ad idem, which also means meeting of minds, which is also essential of a criminal conspiracy. In order to prove a criminal conspiracy, there must be evidence to show that there was an agreement between two or more persons to commit an offense. In the Parliament attack case, the accused had never contacted the deceased terrorist on the place, but had helped one of the conspirators to flee a safer place after the incident and was not held guilty as conspirator. No charge of criminal conspiracy can succeed unless if it is shown that several persons have agreed to do an illegal act or lawful act by unlawful means. This implies that there must be meeting of minds resulting in an ultimate decision taken by the conspirators regarding the commission of the offense. In State of Tamil Nadu versus Nalini, which is also known as Rajiv Gandhi assassination case, the Supreme Court had laid down certain important points relating to the offense of criminal conspiracy. Firstly, the association of accused with one of the main accused or even his knowledge about the conspiracy would not make him conspirator as agreement is sine qua non of a conspiracy. Secondly, accused harboring main accused person knowing fully well their involvement in the commission of an offense is itself not sufficient to infer that he was member of conspiracy. Thirdly, if accused has no knowledge about the conspiracy, then his mere association with the main conspirator would not make him the member of the conspiracy. And lastly, it is not necessary for the conspirator to present at the scene of the crime. However, conspirators may be enrolled in a chain, A enrolling B, B enrolling C, and so on, and all will be members of a single conspiracy if they so intend and agree, even though each member knows only the person who enrolled him and the person whom he enrolls. There may be a kind of umbrella spoke enrollment where a single person at the center is doing the enrolling and all other members being unknown to each other, though they know that there are to be other members. Persons may be members of a single conspiracy even though each is ignorant of the identity of many others who may have diverse roles to play. It is not a part of the crime of conspiracy that all the conspirators need to agree to play the same or an active role. Once the object of conspiracy has been achieved, any subsequent act which may be unlawful would not make the accused part of the conspiracy, like giving shelter to absconder. However, a conspirator is not responsible for acts done by co-conspirator after termination of the conspiracy. A criminal conspiracy may come into existence and may and will persist so long as the persons constituting the same remain in agreement and so long as they are acting in accord in furtherance of the common objects for which they have entered into agreement. It is not necessary that each conspirator should be aware of all the acts done by each of the conspirator in the course of conspiracy. However, the acts done by any of the conspirators in the furtherance of the purpose of the conspiracy are merely indication of what the object of conspiracy was. A conspirator can join the conspiracy at any stage, similarly leave it at any stage. However, where different group of persons cooperate towards their separate ends without any privity with each other, each combination constitutes a separate conspiracy. Now, another element of Section 120A Indian Penal Code, which is illegal act. There can be no conspiracy if the act is not illegal. According to Section 43 of Indian Penal Code, illegal is applicable to everything which is an offense prohibited by law or which furnishes ground for an action. Act includes an illegal omission also. Actus reus in a conspiracy is the agreement to execute illegal conduct and not the execution of it. It is not enough that two or more persons pursued the same unlawful object at the same time or in the same place. It is necessary to show meeting of minds, a consensus to effect an unlawful purpose. However, it is not necessary that each conspirator should have been in communication with each other. The overt act necessary to be proved to establish conspiracy includes, first, acts signifying agreement, secondly, acts preparatory to the offense, and thirdly, acts constituting the offense itself. To sustain a charge of criminal conspiracy to do an illegal act, the prosecution must prove the committing of an illegal act by the conspirator. If the conspiracy is merely to do an act which is not illegal, though in the hope and belief that act may result in the death or injury to some persons, that does not amount to an illegal act. For example, if A and B agree that they will induce Y to point his finger at X, believing that Y is endowed with some special power which will enable him to kill by so doing, there is no agreement to do an illegal act and no conspiracy to commit an offense. Every conspiracy involves an element of illegality or illegal act. It is immaterial whether the illegal act is the ultimate object of the agreement or is merely incidental to it. Since an act may be illegal without being criminal, it follows that an agreement to do an illegal act may amount to criminal conspiracy, though it may not be punishable as such. It may be an offense to conspire with another to do an act which, if done alone, would not be criminal. If one conspires with another to employ illegal means to achieve a legal purpose, one may be convicted for conspiracy. For example, obtaining credit without means to pay, though not criminal, is unlawful. It has been held that it is criminal to conspire to enable a person to get goods on credit by means of a false certificate, knowing that he did not intend to pay for them. Where the agreement is not to commit an offense, but to commit an illegal act, or an act which is not illegal by illegal means, it does not amount to criminal conspiracy unless some act besides the agreement is done by one or more parties to the agreement in pursuance thereof. Once a conspiracy to commit an illegal act is proved, act of one conspirator becomes the act of another. The conspiracy can be inferred from circumstances giving rise to exclusive or irresistible inference of an agreement between two or more persons to commit an offense. Now, I will deal with commencement and continuance of criminal conspiracy. The conspiracy to commit a crime and the crime itself are two different offenses. The conspiracy precedes the commission of the crime and is complete before the crime is attempted or completed. Although conspiracy is committed as soon as the agreement for an unlawful object is made, it is clear that conspiracy is a continuing offense and is committed not only when agreement is first reached, but also as long as the agreement to effect the unlawful object continues. Thus, a conspiracy is a continuing offense and continues to subsist and committed wherever one of the conspirators does an act or series of acts, so long as its performance continues. It is a continuing offense till it is executed or resented or frustrated by choice of necessity. To make out an offense of criminal conspiracy, it does not suffice to establish that a number of persons had a common intention to commit an act opposed to or forbidden by the law. It has further to be proved that they agreed to commit the relevant act. The gist of the offense of criminal conspiracy to commit offense lies in the agreement or the common intention of the accused, and the question whether such an agreement or common intention exists is a matter of inference to be deducted from the facts of the case and the acts of the accused, proved in evidence and alleged to have been committed by them in pursuance of such agreement or common intention. Now, I will deal with conviction. It is not essential that more than one person should be convicted of the offense of criminal conspiracy. It is enough that the court is in a position to find out that two or more persons were actually concerned in the criminal conspiracy. For example, an occasion may arise when conspiracy is proved against three conspirators, but two of the three conspirators are not before the court for the reasons beyond the control of the prosecution. In such a case, even one conspirator can be duly convicted and sentenced. If pursuant to a criminal conspiracy, the conspirators commit several offenses, then all of them will be liable for the offenses, even if some of them had not actively participated in the commission of the offenses. When several persons are charged of the offense of criminal conspiracy and all the accused except one is acquitted, the conviction of the remaining one accused on that charge is illegal. The reason for this is simple, that the conspiracy requires an agreement and one cannot conspire with himself. Section 120B of the Indian Penal Code provides for punishment of criminal conspiracy. It states in clause 1, Whoever is a party to the criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable with death, imprisonment for life, or rigorous imprisonment for a term of 2 years or upward shall, where no express provision is made in this code for the punishment of such a conspiracy, be punished in same manner as if he had abetted such offense. Clause 2 of Section 120B states that whoever is a party to a criminal conspiracy other than a criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable as aforesaid shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term not exceeding 6 months or with fine or with both. Thus, Section 120B of the Indian Penal Code prescribes the punishment for criminal conspiracy. The section prescribes punishment for two offenses of varying gravity. First, criminal conspiracy as such, and second, criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable with at least 2 years or more of rigorous imprisonment. Moreover, Section 120B of Indian Penal Code is supplementary as criminal conspiracies. It is a settled law that for an offense under this section, the prosecution need not necessarily prove that perpetrators expressly agreed to do or caused to be done the illegal act. The agreement may be proved by necessary implication. Criminal conspiracy is an offense created and made punishable by the Indian Penal Code. The offense of criminal conspiracy to commit a crime is different from the crime and the object of the conspiracy, because the conspiracy precedes the commission of crime and is complete before the crime is attempted or completed. Equally, the crime is attempted does not require the element of conspiracy as one of the ingredients. In one of the cases of State of Bihar versus Kailash, where the accused was the license holder of a shop and there was evidence that he used to visit the offices. However, it was not proved that he filed any of the fabricated challans. The only circumstance against him was that he knew of the past challans and must have been benefited by the fraud. Therefore, the evidence of his being member of the conspiracy consisted of the commission of the offences themselves by the others. In this case, the court held that it could not be said that the charge of conspiracy had not been proved against him. In Niranjan versus State of Punjab, where three persons entered into a conspiracy to defraud the bank by encashing the forged bank draft, one accused obtained the blank bank draft, second accused forged signature on it, and third accused opened a bank account in a fictitious name and encashed forged draft, and then he destroyed the passbook. All the three accused were held guilty of conspiracy on being prosecuted. One of the accused pleaded that he only tried to oblige the others and did not know anything more. The court rejected his plea and held that under the given circumstances, he was the co-conspirator. In another case, Sushil Suri versus Central Bureau of Investigation, the Supreme Court held that where two chartered accountants had dishonestly and fraudulently opened several fictitious accounts in some banks with an intention and object to facilitate of bank finance for the purpose other than stated in the loan application, the accused person submitted to the bank fake and forged invoices of fictitious and non-existent supplier. The essential ingredient of criminal conspiracy is agreement to commit offense between accused and the commission of crime. Alone is not sufficient to bring the accused under Section 120B of the Indian Penal Code. The appellant with directors and chartered accountant defrauded the revenue and in the process cheated the public exchequer of crores of rupees. Now I will summarize the presentation. To constitute criminal conspiracy, there are certain essentials that must be there. First essential is that an agreement must be there between two or more persons, and such an agreement must be to do an illegal act or to do a legal act by illegal means, and an overt act done in pursuance of the conspiracy is essential. As I have earlier stated, that the essence of conspiracy is the agreement and an association to break the law or to do an illegal act. It is essential that the offense of conspiracy requires some kind of physical manifestation of the agreement. Conspiracy comes into being just the moment the agreement to commit the crucial act is reached, and it continues to exist so long as the object for which the association was formed continues in the process of fulfillment as per agreement. Offense of criminal conspiracy is complete even though there is no agreement as to the means by which the purpose is to be accomplished. Two or more persons are essential for an offense of criminal conspiracy under section 120A of the Indian Penal Code. When two or more persons agree to commit a criminal conspiracy, then regardless of making or considering any plans for its commission, and despite the fact that no steps is taken by any such person to carry out their common purpose, a crime is committed by each and everyone who joins in the agreement. Another essential which is required for an offense of criminal conspiracy is meeting of minds or consensus ad idem. In order to prove offense of criminal conspiracy, there must be evidence to show that there was an agreement between two or more persons to commit an offense. No offense of criminal conspiracy may come into existence and may and will persist so long as persons constituting the same remain in agreement and so long as they are acting in accord in furtherance of the object for which they entered into agreement. The act done by any of the conspirator in furtherance of the purpose of conspiracy are merely indication of what the object of conspiracy was. Another essential requirement of the offense of criminal conspiracy is the illegal act. There can be no criminal conspiracy if the act is not illegal. Illegal has been defined in section 43 of the Indian Penal Code. Act includes an illegal omission also. To sustain a charge of criminal conspiracy to do an illegal act, the prosecution must prove the committing of an illegal act by the conspirator. Every conspiracy involves an element of illegality or illegal act. It is immaterial whether the illegal act is the ultimate object of the agreement or merely incidental to it. Where the agreement is not to commit an offense but to commit an illegal act or an act which is not illegal by illegal means, it does not amount to criminal conspiracy unless some act beside the agreement is done by one or more parties to the agreement in pursuance thereof. A conspiracy is a continuing offense and it continues to subsist and committed wherever one of the conspirator does an act or series of act. To make an offense of criminal conspiracy, it does not suffice to establish that a number of persons had a common intention to commit an act opposed to or forbidden by law. The gist of the offense of criminal conspiracy to commit offense lies in the agreement or the common intention of the accused, and the question whether such an agreement or common intention exists is a matter of inference to be deduced from the facts of the case and the acts of the accused proved in evidence and alleged to have been committed by them in pursuance of such agreement or common intention. It is not essential that more than one person should be convicted of offense of criminal conspiracy. It is enough that court is in position to find out that two or more persons were actually concerned in the criminal conspiracy. For the punishment of criminal conspiracy, section 120B is there in the Indian Penal Code, which prescribes punishment for criminal conspiracy for two offenses of varying gravity. First is criminal conspiracy as such, and second is criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable with at least 2 years or more of rigorous imprisonment. Moreover, section 120B is supplementary to the criminal conspiracy. There are certain cases dealing with criminal conspiracies, like State of Tamil Nadu versus Nalini, which is one of the important cases on criminal conspiracy. Then State of Bihar versus Kailash, Niranjan versus State of Punjab, Sushil Suri versus CBI, which exclusively deals with criminal conspiracy. Thus, it is a settled law that for an offence under this section, the prosecution need not necessarily prove that the perpetrators expressly agreed to do or caused to be done the illegal act. The agreement may be proved by necessary implication. Criminal conspiracy is an offence created and made punishable by the Indian Penal Code. The offence of criminal conspiracy to commit a crime is different from crime itself and the object of the conspiracy, because the conspiracy precedes the commission of crime and is complete before the crime is attempted or completed. Equally, the crime attempted does not require the element of conspiracy as one of the ingredients. If pursuant to criminal conspiracy, the conspirator committed several offences, then all of them will be liable for the offences, even if some of them had not actively participated in the commission of the offence. When several persons charged of the offence of criminal conspiracy and all the accused except one is acquitted, the conviction of remaining one accused on that charge is illegal. The reason is that a conspiracy requires an agreement and one cannot conspire with himself. So essentially what is provided under section 120A of the Indian Penal Code is the important definition of criminal conspiracy. Section 120A of the Indian Penal Code defines the criminal conspiracy, and it says that where two or more persons agree to do or cause to be done an illegal act or an act which is not illegal by illegal means, such an agreement is designated as a criminal conspiracy. So, to constitute a criminal conspiracy, there must be an agreement, and such agreement must be for doing an act which is an illegal act or for doing an act which is not illegal by itself, but doing it by illegal means. There is proviso to that section also which states that no agreement except an agreement to commit an offence shall amount to a criminal conspiracy unless some act besides the agreement is done by one of the more parties to such agreement in pursuance thereof. Thank you.